Hello friends and welcome back to another video from Vipin Sharma Biology Tutorials. In this video we are going to talk about phylum Annelida, right? So we have already talked about Porifera, Coelenterata, Ctenophora, Platyhelminthes and Aeschylminthes in the previous videos. If you do not know anything about all these phylums, then you must watch the previous lectures. Now Annelida, जैसा कि हम लोग हर लेक्चर में करते हैं, सबसे पहले बात करेंगे peculiar feature के बारे में, which is hidden in the name itself. So the Annelida word is formed from another word, that is annulus or annuli. Okay, annulus or annuli, that simply means little ring. So there are little rings or little segments which are present in the body of an annelid. So एक annelid की body segments से बनी होती है, little rings की बनी होती है, जिन्हें हम बोलते हैं metameres. So the most characteristic feature of Annelida is the presence of annulus or little rings and a phenomena that is metameric segmentation. We have already talked about this phenomena in the initial lectures or the introductory lectures of animal kingdom, जब हमने coelom की body division की symmetry की बात की थी. So annulus means little ring which are known as the metamere. Okay, metamere or annulus, these are the little rings. Okay, and the metameric segmentation is the phenomena which is shown by the Annelida. After that, they can be present in different kind of habitat, right? They can be free living. Aapne dekha hoga earthworm, which is the most common example of Annelida. अगर एनेलिडा की आप बात कर रहे हो तो आपके दिमाग में कुछ चीजें आ जानी चाहिए. फॉर एग्जाम्पल द मोस्ट कॉमन थिंग्स सच एज लीच. ओके, यू नो वेरी वेल अबाउट द ब्लड सकिंग लीच, मोस्ट सिंपल थिंग. देन अर्थवॉर्म, आई थिंक दैट मोस्ट ऑफ यू मस्ट हैव सीन द अर्थवॉर्म इन योर लाइफ. एंड नेरिस. व्हाई नेरिस? बिकॉज इट इज द एक्सेप्शन ऑफ सम ऑफ द थिंग्स, राइट? So, इसके बारे में हम बात करेंगे कि नीरिस कैसे एक्सेप्शन है. ये तीन चीजें आपके दिमाग में याद आ जानी चाहिए, लीच, अर्थवॉर्म एंड नीरिस. सो दे कैन बी फ्री लिविंग जस्ट लाइक अर्थवॉर्म, राइट? दे कैन बी एक्वेटिक, मींस दे कैन बी लिविंग इन वॉटर. द वॉटर कैन बी मैराइन वॉटर एज वेल एज फ्रेश वॉटर. दे कैन बी टेरेस्ट्रियल, इट मीन्स दैट दे कैन बी लिविंग ऑन लैंड जस्ट लाइक अर्थवॉर्म. दिमाग में एक इमेज बन जानी चाहिए. दे कैन बी पैरासिटिक एज वेल जस्ट लाइक लीच, बिकॉज लीच इज ब्लड सकिंग इन नेचर. So it is parasitic. These are some habitats. After that, the most simple point from this lecture, which we are discussing from many different lectures, organ system level of organization. Now Porifera, cell aggregated plan. Coelenterata, Ctenophora, tissue level. Platyhelminthes, organ level. And after Platyhelminthes, all of the phylums must be having organ system. Only Coelenterata, Ctenophora and adult echinoderms are having radial symmetry, all other are bilaterally symmetrical, right? Platyhelminthes and rest of the animals are triploblastic. So the triploblastic animals are Porifera, Coelenterata and Ctenophora. So triploblastic means three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. They are coelomate. Only Aeschylminthes is pseudocoelomate, that is having false coelom. Before Aeschylminthes, all the phylums are acoelomate, that are not having coelom, and after Aeschylminthes, all the phylums are having two coelom, which is lined by mesoderm. So it is coming after Aeschylminthes, so it is obviously having two coelom, so it is coelomate. And metamerically segmented, which is the most characteristic feature. Okay, there is a serial repetition of at least some organs outside the body and inside the body. We have already talked about metameric segmentation in the initial lectures. वहां से आप लोग देख सकते हैं there is serial repetition. बाहर से देख के हम कुछ organs का पता लगा सकते हैं कि ये repeat हो रहे होंगे, right? और बाहर से जैसा segmentation दिखता है, अंदर से mostly वैसा ही segmentation हमें मिलता है. This pattern, this specific pattern is known as metameric segmentation. And why metameric? Because the segments are known as metameres or annuli, which are the little ring-like structures. After that, let's talk about nearest, जिसके बारे में हम बात करने वाले थे. It is having parapodia for swimming, right? If some individual such as nearest want to swim, then there are some things which are present in the body that are known as parapodia. Parapodia are the little appendages जो कि nearest की body से निकले होंगे. If this is the nearest, there are some things like that. These are called parapodia, जिसकी मदद से nearest क्या करता है, swim कर पाता है. And how do the other organisms used to swim or how they do move? ये क्या करते हैं, यहाँ पर होती हैं muscles. There are some circular muscles. If you will imagine the structure of an earthworm, there are some longitudinal muscles in the body and there are some circular muscles in the body. Okay, circular muscles and longitudinal muscles. They used to contract them and they used to release them. Contract, release, contract, release. इस तरीके से वो धीरे धीरे आगे बढ़ते जाएंगे. अर्थवॉर्म की कभी मोशन को ऑब्जर्व करके देखना. ही यूज टू कॉन्ट्रैक्ट इट्स बॉडी एंड देन ही यूज टू एक्सटेंड इट. सो ही यूज टू पुश इट्स बॉडी इन द फ्रंट डायरेक्शन और इन द बैकवर्ड डायरेक्शन सो दैट ही कैन मूव विद द हेल्प ऑफ सम लॉन्गिट्यूडनल एंड सर्कुलर मसल देयर कॉन्ट्रैक्शन एंड रिलैक्सेशन. ओके, सो सर्कुलर एंड लॉन्गिट्यूडनल मसल्स फॉर लोकोमोशन आर प्रेजेंट इन मोस्ट ऑफ द एनलिड्स. इन केस ऑफ नीरिस there are little appendages or parapodia which are present which helps it in swimming. So parapodia is the important word. After that, the circulatory system is closed. Let's talk about another feature of nereus, that it is dioecious. Dioecious means unicellular. It means that the male and female are separate. Male nereus alag hoga, female nereus alag hoga. Because when we talk about earthworm, it contains male and female reproductive organs in the same individual. Right? There is no distinction like female earthworm and male earthworm. Both of these sex organs are present in the same individual. But the nereus is unicellular. The male and female are different. So, this is the phylum in which both dioecious and monoecious animals are found. It is having both bisexual, that is earthworm, and unisexual, that is nereus, which is found over here, right? So this is an exception in which we can say both of the things are present. And the similar thing we have studied in the case of fertilization, that one phylum is possessing both type of fertilization, external as well as internal. Similarly, the monoecious character and dioecious character is also found in the Annelida. After that, closed circulatory system is found. It simply means that the blood is flowing through the veins, arteries and capillaries. It is not directly bathing different kind of tissues. वो directly tissues के ऊपर नहीं गिर रहा, नहीं बह रहा, वो एक particular orientation में, particular direction में जा रहा है with the help of some pipe-like structures that are known as vessels. We are very well aware about the vessels. हम human biology पढ़ चुके हैं थोड़ी बहुत, उसमें हमने vessels की बात की थी. So, dioecious is clear that di means two. It means that both male and female are present. Mono means one. It means that in one individual, both the sex organs are present. So, this is about nereus. After that, closed circulatory system is present in it and it is an advanced character. In some of the arthropods, open circulatory system is present. Agar hum evolutionary dekhen relationship, then Porifera, Coelenterata, Tenophora, okay, Platyhelminthes, Aschelminthes, Annelida and Arthropoda. So Arthropoda must be much advanced as compared to Annelida because it is coming after that. Lekin kuch arthropods aise hai jinme open circulatory system hai, but in case of Annelida there is closed circulatory system. So in terms of circulatory system, Annelida is much advanced. This point is very important. Right? After that, there is Nephridia. Nephridia are the excretory organs which helps in the excretion of waste products as well as it helps in the osmoregulation. Just like the flame cells. Flame cells kahan par paaye ja rahe the? Platyhelminthes. So just like the flame cells of Platyhelminthes, we have Nephridia in Annelida. What about the neural system? The neural system can be easily memorized with the help of a very simple diagram. This is an imaginary diagram, right? You don't have to make it in the exam. There is paired ganglia. Paired ganglia. It means the ganglion. So paired is the matlab two in number, right? So let's make the two ganglia which are connected with the lateral nerve. Now nerve is also part of nervous system. So it will be connected with a lateral nerve. This is the nerve. And it is itself attached to the double ventral nerve cord. Okay, so 1, 2 double के लिए हम ये word use कर लेंगे. Double, it is present on the what? Ventral side. Because in case of chordates, it is present on the dorsal side. When we talk about chordates, there is dorsal hollow nerve cord. हम आगे बात करेंगे chordates में. यहाँ पर आपको ये याद रखना है, it is double and ventral nerve cord. Okay, there is a lateral nerve because it is joining them laterally, and these are the paired ganglia. This type of neural system is present in case of annelida. Right? So these are the most important points and facts which you have to memorize in case of annelida. Let's revise the lecture once more. The most important point is annelida, that is annulus or little rings, right? That are known as metameres. It means that the most characteristic feature is metameric segmentation. After segmentation, there are some circular and longitudinal muscles which helps in the locomotion. In case of nereus, the locomotion is via parapodia, which helps in the swimming. After that, the nereus also shows dioecious behavior. It means that the male nereus and the female nereus are separate. There are parasitic forms also, such as leech, jo ki parasitic hoga. And after that, the most important fact is they have closed circulatory system, and they do have nephridia for excretion and osmoregulation. And the neural system will be containing two ganglia, that is the paired ganglia, which are connected via lateral nerve and joined to the double ventral nerve neural system or the double ventral nerve cord. Aap log simply nerve cord bol sakte hain, and these all things are consisting the neural system in case of annelids. So I hope you got the concept very well. Aap logon ko I hope samajh mein aaya ho. Thank you so much guys for watching this video. Share this video with your friends. Subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for sure. Thank you so much.